Ah, il fait froid là-bas! Je comprends pourquoi je mets mon chauffage. Ah oui, merde! Attends, dans une seconde, je te le rends. C'est pas mon fils. Allez! Merci, mais. Ouais, c'est parti. Oups. Ah. Il y a déjà des gens qui attendent. T'aimes.
Quoi? Qu'est-ce que t'aimes? Fais-moi un bisou.
T'aimes. Ouais, c'est parti. Ah, c'est parti. Ok, j'ai pas de perte là-dessus par contre, c'est cool. 8 personnes? Ouais. Salut Maxper, je sais pas si tu m'entends, si tu m'entends dis-le moi.
You'll get used to it. Give it 10 or 15 years. Here he comes! Down, Pedro! Incoming!
Help! Help!
this place was abandoned? How come it still smells like sweetener and despair?
Proximity alert. Biology human. Attempting to disengage security protocols without proper authorization is a fireable offense. Priming weapons. Executive level password accepted as identification according to employee ID protocol A-3501. Welcome back, Doctor. Be advised. Mantisaur threat level is petrifying purple berry. Please use caution. Mantisaur wounds are not covered under Rizzo's health policy. Have a productive day.
Everywhere.
life seems awful cushy. Could get myself used to kicking back from it.
Our fuel cells are now primed with Alta Vitae gas. As the organics say, let us hope we do not The Groundbreaker has approved our request for docking, Captain. You're free to disembark.
Hey, Doc Fenhill.
Hey, Tobias. How's the...
Good as you left it, ma'am. Took some extra lead while I was on a job. Ellie here patching me up good. The other guy...
Workplace hazards, Captain. Pretty routine around.
Swell. Has anyone from HR given you the new employee talk? I don't actually know. Here goes. Welcome to Sublight, where salvage runs thicker than blood. Glad to have you on board. We could use the help after...
That gas is going to make us a fucking mint. 120-some cubic meters of it, at a million bits a pop. Take this, you've earned it. When we get buyers lined up, I'm gonna buy a gold toilet to shit in. You're goddamn right. Monarch isn't exactly a walk down the lanes of Byzantium. But here you are with all your limbs attached. Call me impressed, contractor. I guess you're just one of the lucky ones. Look on the bright side. You just started and you're already on the path to a promotion. You've been keeping busy. I hear you took on some extra work at Fallbrook. Catherine sounds pleased as a pig in shit over cornering the Borst markets. Hey. When you were at the slaughterhouse, those swine didn't give you any strange looks, did they? I knew it. I'm probably getting worked up over nothing. Just try not to think about pigs. Attaboy. I have another job lined up, assuming you're still interested in work. You're gonna salvage me a space station. Heliospheric Research Station 1084, to be exact. I want it. Cobwebs and all. Interested?
Sounds like a major business expansion. It pays to get in on those early, you know.
This opportunity won't come around again, Captain. Right now, it's only salvage on paper. Systems and comms have gone dark. Poke around if you're curious why. While the board lets 1084... Here, this override bypass should get you into the station systems where you can plant my flag. And one last thing. When you get there, make sure you aren't followed. We wouldn't want that. glad we understand each other. I'm on the heels of something big. Play your cards right and I'll clue you in, but right now, I'm not sure who I can trust. Just be careful. Someone might try and use you to get to me.
Some crew members are causing a disturbance on the ship. Welcome back, Captain. How can I be of assistance? May luck be with you. We've reached HRS-1084, Captain. It's emitting a very weak docking signal. I almost mislabeled it as normal etheric static. I'll lock up behind you. Think there's a generator somewhere? Sure, there are a lot of charging automechs. What are the chances they're friendly? Oh, I see you have activated your holographic shroud, Captain. Excellent. Becoming indistinguishable from an authentic... A UDL vessel has been tracking our position and just recently docked with the station. They are patching into the station's transmission lines now. I cannot stop...
I've been waiting for this day since we tagged your ship in Cascadia, Captain. Wait, who are you? Roger that. Just as a precaution, I'm sure you won't mind if we turn on the station's security systems. Can't be too careful. We'd hate to leave this location undefended after a close call with outlaws. Shit. Thanks for the warning. Last thing I need is to get fined for overriding security on a restricted station. My team and I will just head out then.
The UDL gunship is undocking from the station. They appear to be departing into space.
I ought to try talking more and fighting less. Seems like it saves on ammunition.
Nice and easy.
Watch your step.
Let's go get our money before Sublight sees what a creepy dump this place is. Wait, Bertrand? We've seen that name before, back in Cascadia.
Captain, I wish to offer my commendations for convincing the UDL's gunship to leave HRS-1084. I did not favor the idea of being... The Groundbreaker has approved our request for docking, Captain. You're free to disembark. Please avoid damage to yourself or others.
Finally, a base of our own. Soon we'll have eyes on every corner of the system. Well done, Captain. I'll have those dismantled. You can never be too careful when moving into someone else's territory. Aside from the automated I knew it. They've been shadowing us since Monarch, maybe even longer. I've been less than honest with you. That's right. Up until now, I've kept you in the dark for your protection, and more importantly, mine. But I'd like to think we've earned each other's trust. After the Monarch job, I started connecting the dots. I didn't like the picture. Then what we found at Station 1084 confirmed my fears. You and I have stumbled onto something big, something none of us were meant to know. I'm thinking more along the lines of the sapient species paradox. Ask yourself why a skeleton crew was studying that Alta Vitae gas in secret. Ask yourself why stockpiles were hidden on a planet full of monsters. Before we go any further, I want you to keep an open mind. Can you do that for me, Captain? Aliens. I'm talking about aliens. They're the ones responsible for the deaths at 1084, and who knows what else. We have to put a stop to it. Hear me out. I'm saying it's aliens. I'm not asking you to like it. I'm not even asking you to believe it. But I need to act on this threat to the colony, and I can't do it alone.
Well, at least she doesn't expect us to believe it.
Right. I'm done. I'm officially tuning you out until such time as I hear the words payment and or shooting.
The crew is skeptical. That's good. I don't want you walking into the unknown with blindfolds on. I assume you have questions? If we're gonna see this through, conspiracy. One carried out with the help of human collaborators, assuming they haven't all been replaced. This is an invasion of our very no kidding. That's how they want it. When I lined up the evidence in my spreadsheet, there were... Sharing my findings took a calculated risk. If you were a spy, I'd... Tobias, get my knife. The big one. That was a joke. Ha ha. We... Dr. Chartrand is the crooked psychopath behind the gas experiments. She sold out her species. I need you to put a bullet through her skull.
Straight to business, huh, Captain?
This key card will get you through the front door of her Byzantium estate. Don't ask how I got it. You might not like the answer. By now, the other side knows what you're doing. Don't trust anything Chartrand says. She's compromised down to the bone. Maybe even deeper than that.
now in orbit above Byzantium, Captain. Good luck, Captain.
Not so fast. All right, you're clear. The adjutant's expecting you. Go on through.
I admit, part of me expected you to stand by your old friend. For better or worse, I understand you've infiltrated the Ministry. The things you discovered there must have been shocking, even disturbing. Halcyon is on the verge of a total systems collapse. The truth is ugly and difficult to accept, but malnutrition is already a problem. Disease will come next, followed by starvation, followed by a breakdown of society, followed by extinction. I know this must come as a surprise to you. I imagine you have questions.
Guess Monarch folk ain't the only ones fucked around here. That ain't exactly an uplifting thought.
I know your face. Stellar Bay's most infamous hunter. How curious that you've thrown your lot in with the captain. Monarch may harbor delusions of independence, but make no mistake. You are a part of our colony. If we fall, Monarch falls with us.
What's in this for you? There's gotta be an angle. There always is for people like you.
I appreciate your skepticism, Dr. Fenhill, but I'm not doing this for any personal gain. My angle is the preservation of our colony by any means possible. Nothing more and nothing less. I won't pretend the truth isn't damning. Yes, the colony is on the verge of collapse. But there is a way to save it. We need to talk about Emerald Vale. You handed Edgewater over to a band of dissidents. I can't have this. Adelaide McDevitt and her people have no place in the Halcyon that is to come. Edgewater needs to go. I want you to wipe the town out. No survivors.
I get that you board types are all about efficiency, but isn't this a bit much?
I'm asking your captain to amputate a rotting limb from the colony. I'd expect you to understand, Dr. Fenhill.
I will hunt beasts until I'm out of ammunition, and then I'll fight a good long while after. But I am not about to mow down a crowd of innocent people.
Then I suggest you find your courage, or pretend you're hunting beasts. Now is not the time for half measures, Captain. You replaced a loyal, if hard-headed, town leader with a revolutionary. Adelaide's people have turned Edgewater into a hub of dissidents. These people are dangerous. They're going to become more dangerous after because we were negligent. You're right, the colony can't possibly feed itself, and it's our fault. This is our mess, and the only way we're cleaning it up is by taking action. I'm not asking you to be a murderer. I'm asking you to be a surgeon. Don't fool yourself. The dissidents occupying Edgewater are rebels harboring dangerous and seditious ideas. Left to their own devices, their numbers will grow. Graham Bryant and his merry band. No, Allowing thousands of colonists to starve to death because we couldn't make one cold-blooded decision is insane. What I'm suggesting is absolutely logical. Steel your spine, Captain. Edgewater is beyond saving. We're going to have to erase the town, but we're going to do it systematically. You were in the Emerald Vale geothermal plant. Do you remember what you discovered there? There was an accident at the Emerald Vale geothermal plant many years ago. Automechanicals turned hostile and slaughtered the plant's workers. Tragic, really. In fact, Spacer's Choice manufactured the incident. The insurance claim has been locked in committee for years, but the individual responsible for the accident was promoted for lateral thinking. I'm arranging for a delivery of mechanicals to Edgewater. These mechanicals have been equipped with the same termination protocol, which must be activated from a terminal in the plant. Once the mechanicals are finished cleaning out Edgewater, I'll need you to go in and clean out the mechanicals. Understand? I appreciate the flattery, Captain. One last thing. Spacer's Choice. I like you, Captain, but you're not worth that much paperwork. I prefer keeping our relationship strictly off the books. Report back to me when the job's done.
This reminds me of... Oh, never mind. Make me nervous. Experiments always go wrong.
That's far enough. What are you doing here? How did you even get inside?
If anyone ever tries to off me, I hope they do it with the same professional courtesy.
Hagen? I've never heard of her. Is she from the board? Damn it. I knew this would happen. This is utter nonsense. I've never even been to Groundbreaker. What happened to the team? Tell me you didn't move their suspension tanks. Small consolation. My team, the finest minds of their generation, reduced to salvage. We were trying to prove that the colony could survive the crisis bearing down on us.
What are you doing, Doctor? This information is beyond classified.
You can write me up in your report. It hardly matters. I'm researching a new way to feed the colony. The crops we transplanted from Earth don't give us the nutrients we need. Our colonists might not realize it yet, but they're starving. Then you know how desperate things are. I believed that I could adapt humans to live on Halcyon's terms. That I could change us. Not for lack of trying. I wanted to save them all, but I wasn't strong enough. I wouldn't allow us to experiment on convicts or the unemployed. It's wrong, no matter what the law says. Everyone agreed. We accepted the risks. I'm desperate. I've already asked all the best institutes. It's been missing for over 2 years now. They never reestablished contact after the skip to Earth. Of course, the board is keeping that under wraps.
Imagine losing something with that many guns on it.
That ain't a shock. Board folks will lie to their own mothers if it preserves their paychecks.
The board is uneasy about letting the colony know, seeing as half of their military force vanished without a trace. I'd prefer if you didn't use my name when you talk about this. My contract has a list of very terrible consequences for breaking secrecy. Once we can replicate a success, the board will move to rewire our nucleon. With any luck, our next generation will be eating and thriving off Halcyon crops.
Knowing what the board considers a success, that doesn't give me a lot of hope.
Fuck that. People are people, and ought to stay the way they were born. They start trying to tinker with my blood, I'll bury them.
We haven't made enough strides to advance the plan. You came to kill me. I assume that's still on the table. Please don't. If I die, there's no one who can reproduce our work. Every sacrifice will have been for nothing. And will be no closer.
I try not to, least when it comes to the moral dilemmas. Lilia Hagen's a useful ally to have, but I'll back you up either way.
I hope you know what you're doing, Captain.
Look, cold-blooded murder ain't easy on my spirits. But this, all this research, all these experiments, it's wrong. It's all void damn wrong.
Everything I did, the one on the wanted posters, they say he's an anarchist, a madman, a butcher. I'll do it.
Doctor!
What choice do I have, Commander? Alien conspiracy? No. What? Did you hit your head on your way in or something? I need to get out of here. Phineas can contact me when he's ready to work together. For now, I had better pack up the lab and head somewhere discreet.
Not so fast. Captain, what you just learned is beyond your clearance. Hell, it's beyond mine. Give me one reason why I should let you walk out of here alive. Wrong answer.
Wait.
What?
Just like...
you
Nice work dispatching Chartrand, Captain. The Groundbreaker has approved our request for docking, Captain. You're free to disembark.
Is it done? Well, well. Looks like someone's due for a promotion. How does Vice President of Aggressive Acquisitions sound to you, Contractor? You've certainly earned it, my blood-soaked rising star. Catherine heard I was taking you on full-time and sent along a present of her own. I've had it delivered to your ship. From now on, the board will think twice before fucking with Lilia Hagen, savior of humanity. Be sure to mention that in your travels. We could use the free advertising.
Hey, we don't work for exposure.
I wish more legitimate businesses were like yours, Hagen. We get a lot more done.
Well, if there's nothing else, I need to review some applications, seeing as I just lost my best contractor. These days, the scrap business all but runs itself. Gives me the... Our field is persuasive acquisitions. At least, that's how my legal advisors tell me to phrase it. Not all of our salvage is abandoned when we find it. Your words, not mine. Hey, careful with the C word around here. I like to keep things above board, and that kind of talk only makes trouble. Sublight occupies a legal blind spot. No one knows what we're licensed to do. Ask. Not as much as I'd like. The board dispatched it to Earth on a resupply mission, I think. Interesting. It's possible the board wanted the cruiser to disregard ancillary tasks. But to what end? I'll have someone look into it. You weren't followed, were you? I don't charge for very. I have this thing about numbers in spreadsheets. Grids. I like to think of myself as...
Chicken.